This is the last part of our presentation. So up to now, you, I hope, drinking your afternoon coffee, you had the opportunity to see what we have done up to now, and yeah, to have the flavor of the challenges and even though the good results that we have. And now it's time to invite you to join us either as a contributor or as a user, and to help us develop this big corpus with more parliaments, and also to develop the scheme, to develop the use cases even more, and to get out of the use cases and to go to real applications. That's what we aim at. So we already issued a call about this, about the contribution, further contribution. And I just want to point to some of the basic points. And of course, we have some time after that for discussion, and you can ask your questions, and to the previous speakers as well. We saw that it's good to have such comparable collection of really contemporary parliaments for four languages, yeah. But we would like to have more. So the submission deadline is coming, but there is still time. It's 16th of November. The results, we hope, will be announced 20th of November. We have also Quarry in office to help with this. And we would like the projects, the mini projects, to start on 1st of December. And since the good thing about what happens now, the first phase and the second phase, is that we already went through this path, and we saw that it's possible to do this work. And we also have enough experience how to do it and where the challenges are. So we do hope that for you it will be really better and really less stressful, so to say. But I can assure you that the result is worth it. So the delivery of this corpora, the COVID one and the previous pre-corona one, we expect to be ready by 13th of March next year. So to be more specific, what we expect from you, we expect updating that you obtain this contemporary data from your parliaments, and you provide the reference parts of the corpus, as it was said by Maciej, the periods. Then you do the conversion of the data into parliament format developed by Tomasz and Andrei over the parallel format one. And then you can proceed with your tool or with the available tools on Universal Dependencies page to linguistically process your data. And it would be great if you also add named entity recognition module. And at the end, of course, producing some documentation on the provided corpus, which is very focused and not so big burden, but it's very useful for the comparison. And what we provide from our site, guidelines on how to prepare the data, and of course, consultations and what is needed, we are there. The already existing corpora that are in GitHub and their models for the next corpora, the parliament schema, the header, the corpora themselves, everything is there. Then upload to the concordancers that you already saw, and upload to Parlameter as the first transition phase to real case, real cases, real world cases, actually. So we have 5,000 euro per mini project, and the duration is more or less 4 months for the compilation and development and conversion of this corpora. So the assessment criteria are the qualifications of the team involved and the status of the available and or accessible parliamentary data. Of course, it is up to you. You are the people to judge what is the work that is expected from you, whether you already have it, whether it's easy to obtain, whether you have enough people to do it. It depends because it's different everywhere. We aim at diversity of parliaments and languages, and of course, the potential with respect to the project goals that you heard about up to now. So it was really very briefly about the call, just to let some more time for your questions, and just a few words about if you want to join as a user. Of course, you saw that we are at the end of the first phase, right? So I also I'm really looking forward to do some user-oriented work myself now with what we have. But three showcases are envisaged. Parlometer showcase. This is the graphical exploration of the corpus, and it is very suited to investigations by political scientists, journalists, and active citizens. And actually, all the corpora are there now, just they are being polished, and it will be really available maybe next week or even this one. Then, extending the Clarin tutorial, Voices of the Parliament, very, very useful one. And we hope that our experience will help to develop it further and to be even more useful in a specialized social cultural context or political discourse. Also, as you already heard, we have a digital historian that will have our data and your data, the contributors' data, to develop digital humanities related showcase. So just to finish, you do not have to wait for all this to come. You can start exploring the corpora even now, and not only the corpora through the concordances, but also the schema and the corpora and everything that we developed and that we put publicly available. One example, very quick example, if I may. So it is just two slides, and what I tried to do even now was to see how the word unemployment was used by women that are member of the parliament from the socialist opposition, and then by women of the ruling party. And so, just in very, very short, the opposition usually gets the focus on the compensation and the right for compensation. And it comes first as most frequent word. And what about the ruling party, the women there? They say that the funds and what the state has as instruments to help the people and the budget and everything, and the compensation is not so frequent. So I will stop here.